Okay, here's another video of my IS300. This is a quick oil change. I have everything ready. So what you want to do is jack up your car using the jack stand so you can have some clearance to drain the oil down here. There's a 14 millimeter. Okay, there's a 14 millimeter right there. You want to drain that, and it's located on the passenger side. Of course, you, like I said, you got to jack up your car to get access to that nut. Once you've done that, you want to take off your oil cap so you can drain the oil better. And the manufacturer recommendation is 50-30. And today I use Vavilon high mileage foam synthetic. I think you need 5.5 or 5.75 quart. I have some more on the back. So yeah, basically my oil filter is on it's over here. The white thing is the oil filter. And to get it out, and you want to get it out from the top because I think it's impossible to get from bottom. You want to take off this, take this off. There's a little nuts over here. Just move this to the side so you can wiggle the filter out from over here to outside. So let it drain about a couple minutes, and then this is side 12, and you want to loose the bracket that's holding this. I think it's power steering fluid. Oh yeah, and you want to remove this dipstick too, and put it to the side. All right, so you just push this to the way. I know it's only a couple inch. It's only a couple inch, but it make a lot of difference. So now you want to take the hand loose the filter. So the trick is to use a plastic bag. And the filter is in here, and everything is in here. And here's my new filter. It's best practice to pour some oil in here and loop around the ring. And you just put it back in. Same way you got it out. So that's it. And don't forget to put back the power steering dipstick. So put back the dipstick. Put back the drain plug. Okay, once you pour your oil in, and don't forget to take out the jack stand. Lower your car. Okay, then just pour in some oil. I don't know I think about 4 or 5 quart, but I don't go by the manual. But usually you pour it into, it reaches in the middle, at least right here, the second notch. Okay, once you're done all that, you want to start your car for 5 minutes and make sure there's no leaking or any funny sounds. That's just for my AC water. Just check everything. Make sure there's no lights in your dash. And just let the car warm up. And after that, just turn it off and you're done.